Give me a second, guys. Okay. All right. So, not sure what happened. Got major restream issues one more time. I thought I was streaming, apparently not for the past 10 minutes. Sorry about that. Yeah, we're on now. I was doing a lot of talking to myself, which, you know, it's pretty much par for the course for me. But we will get started. Hopefully this is still going. And yeah, we will continue our Fire Emblem playthrough. So here we go. That's Jared. He went to Jared. I don't understand. What is he doing that I cannot use him? It's really, really dumb. Whatever. All right. I could do this. I got the Black Knight. I'll be totally fine. I'm not worried. I wonder if I can talk to him. I can't. Zyhar, you're like ridiculous. I cannot believe you're so weak. More people. Yay. Boom. Lovely. This is interesting. So I can't get up that way without using a ranged character to attack. Let's just see what happens. Maybe he'll go after Tormid, and Tormid will survive. That's not good. Oh my gosh, he missed two attacks! Good lord. Alright, well, this makes me angry. This is very dumb on my part. Probably shouldn't have done that. Heal this guy. Well, okay. Here's what I'll do. I'll heal him, bring him back, and then I will grab Raphael. No, actually, this works perfectly. That's what I'll do. How do you keep missing? What the heck? What the heck is going on? Finally. Just need to grab... Oh, I didn't mean to do that. We're good, we're good, we're good. Ooh! Damn, fire damage is like ridiculous. Finally, killed someone. I guess arc fire just really doesn't have a good hit range. Yeah, it's 80, but it's not that much less. Easy. Alright, send you up here. That was easy. Okay. These guys are all gonna try and... Maybe I shouldn't have brought them up here. He didn't take any damage. I wonder if he got poisoned. Alright, this has just been trash from the beginning. I am going to restart. Okay. Let's try this again. Because that was utter garbage. And should be good now. Alright. Let's try this again. I, like, totally forgot that I should have sent certain people up and... Ugh. What a dumb thing to do on my part. Why don't I just send him up here? Can't be hit. Or at least can't be hurt through normal means. There you go. Great. Let's go. Good. So the Black Knight wears armor blessed by the goddess, so it can't be killed, or it can't be hurt or cut through by normal weapons. But I guess that doesn't count for poison weapons. Interesting. Why do you only shoot once? I don't understand you. So, when these guys come, I'll actually be prepared this time. Let's see how this goes. So those are assassins, I think. Pretty sure. Okay. Should be able to kill him. That's what I pay you for. Well, I mean, you're volunteering to do this, but I would if you really wanted me to. So I wonder how her magic is against... Okay, so it's not good. But she's also got a pretty high resistance. I think she could be... I think she could be okay. I don't know, we'll see. Yeah, she's got really high magic resistance, so she should be okay. And if I... Well, let's see how this does against... I just need you to hit him one more time. There we go. Alright, so I'm gonna redo this for Micaiah. Take care of this guy. What? Dude. Are you kidding me? What does this guy have? That's insane. That's absolutely, absolutely insane. I like genuinely cannot believe that he was able to block two attacks from the strongest character, one of the strongest characters in the entire game. That's mind-blowingly crazy. Just a normal guy. Man. I don't even know at this point. Okay. Let's try it again. See how this works. Yeah, that's what I thought would happen. That's what should have happened the first time. I wonder if I can... wake him up again. Let's see how this happens. He should be able to get up. I just don't think he can move very far. Yeah. Alright, so he's good. I'm gonna send Soth up along with Leo. And then I'm gonna move. I'll send Zyhark up with them just to keep them safe. Everyone else should be okay. Just in case. Alright, let's go. Stupid. Now he's poisoned. I think I have her with recover though, right there. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Not something I would recommend doing. Even if it worked out well for that one guy. Okay. God, why does everyone have a hand axe? Every single freaking person in here. Oh, he's got one left. Are you freaking kidding me? How ridiculous is that? Youch. What does a Reaper card do? Special item that lets non-magic users launch a moderately powerful magical attack. It's kind of cool. Have absolutely no use for it, but it's pretty cool. We're doing okay. How many? We still have a crap ton of people to kill. It's just getting up to the level. That's the hardest part. Alright, we gotta move people up now. Tormek can come over here. Vika, I don't even know why she's here. She's so weak. Alright, let's see what happens. Of course he's gonna heal him. Stupid. So stupid. Well, this is dumb. Let's see what happens. I should have done it with a different sword because he only had 3 uses left. Whatever. Ugh. What? What? Why? Screw it. I don't care. I'm not going back. The one character I was trying to really train up. It's ridiculously stupid. Ugh. It really pisses me off. There we go. Wonder how this would go. I could try. Kind of figured. There we go. Well, people can come up now. All right, well, we tried. Everybody has freaking wind edges. I don't get it. Where are they getting all these magic items from? Wow, you got 1 coin. I feel so happy for you. This is like relentless. Okay. Good. I mean, these guys can't really do anything. It's gonna be crazy difficult for them to get up. I already have that. Good. All right. Okay. Should be good at holding them off for the most part. Thank you. Great. I guess she can come up here. She got nothing better to do. Good. Nice. He can definitely hold all of those mages off by himself. Especially with the height advantage. Nice. Ugh. Ridiculous. Wow. I mean, might as well. She can't die. Oh boy. Yeah, she can't, it's like impossible to kill her, essentially, right now. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Might not have been the best course of action. Oh, well. Should have kept that door closed. Yeah, at least he can only be hit from so far. Much better performance than last time, Tormod. Okay. That's the only thing, is she can't do ranged attacks. This guy, on the other hand, is just stealing crap left and right. Crazy. She's so strong though, like, really. Whoever designed this level needs to die. They just need to be murdered. Yeah, if you're gonna ask me to do that, just text me. Because I'm, like, on. Give me a sec. Hey, guys. Give me 1 second. I gotta take a quick break. I'll be right back. Thank you. Alright, I'm back. Sorry. Why did I... That was so dumb. I'm gonna have to restart this. He's not supposed to die! I gotta restart this, because he's not supposed to die. This entire game is way too complicated at the very beginning, with way few characters that are strong as they need to be. There's so many characters that are just... They're just underpowered, you know? It's ridiculous. Hopefully this will go better this time. I genuinely don't understand how some of these enemies work. They're just like naturally dodgy. In the first game, it felt a lot more fair in that regard, where you could go up against people who were stronger than you, but their stats didn't necessarily mean that you couldn't beat them, you know, with weaker characters. This one is like, nope, everyone's just way stronger than you, everyone can defend you, or defend against you. It's just really, really, really annoying. Right next to you, how do you miss him? I would expect a unit near a boss, which is probably going to be like a general of some sort, to be able to do that, but not like a random... he's a Myrmidon, he's not even a swordmaster, he's below a swordmaster, and he can still dodge out of the way of a sage, which is just insane. Twice! That's so ridiculous. It just blows my mind. There we go. What I would like to do is... Maybe I can't do that. What I would like to do is get the thieves, the assassins that come in, these guys, and kill them so that they can stop stealing shit. Go. Yeah. Perfect. Finally did something. That's how it should go. All right, let's get up here. See, that was stupid on my part. I should have done it the other way around. Urgh! So stupid. Because now she can't get up, and now I'm gonna have the same problem I had before. This map pisses me off so much. It's just so stupidly designed to make it frustrating. Not to make it fun, to make it ridiculously frustrating. Which is... It's not how games should work, in my opinion. This isn't Dark Souls, right? This is Fire Emblem. It's supposed to be fun and interesting, but not necessarily super difficult. Especially on this difficulty. This is just the normal difficulty level. Alright, well... Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna send her up, because she, like, cannot die. It's, like, impossible to kill her. She's just gonna take care of everyone up there, and everyone else will catch up. Really? It's got a six... He's lucky. That's the only thing I can say that's good about him. That's what I wanted. Okay. This guy is just stealing everything. Very happy you can shoot through a pillar. I mean, that's impressive. It's not physically possible, but I'm glad he can do it. There you go. It's a freaking bandit. Who does that? It's very strange. There we go. Yes, everyone go after her. She's just so good at dodging. This is your moment, Sothie. Okay. She's doing all right. She's good. I really just have to get this guy before he gets whatever's in here. I can get these two. Very easy. I'm gonna send more of them over here. Yeah, this should be good. Good. Actually know what I should do for this. Yeah, he's got way too good magic resistance. Alright, I'll just send him over here, heal him up. whatever. Hopefully there's no more people that come in behind me, because that would suck. Freaking thing. Great. Perfect. Well, I don't have to worry about the meteor anymore. So I'm gonna send him in here. Heal him up. Maybe he can attack. Well, I don't know. We'll see what happens. Should be okay. I completely forgot about these guys. That's what happens. You get locked in. Oh, I forgot a good punch. That's awesome. Yet again, does not attack a second time. Really loving you, dude. Really gonna hurt Tormud, like, at all. Okay. Freaking ranged characters, man. I swear to God. Okay, well, that's definitely not good. This is what you get for stealing everything on the entire map. That's all I got, was a card. Wow. Bonk. All right, well. Just writhes in pain. I love it. Here we go. Okay. You up here, freaking kill you. All right, should be good. He doesn't even fly, he just walks. Great. Yeah, whatever. I'll try it. Not bad. There we go. Did I not open that last chest? What am I doing? Just wait around for another one, I guess. Alright, Lara, you gotta fix this. You gotta fix this right now. There we go. Can it really not go up? It has to use the stairs? It's the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. That's nice. Alright, how strong is he? He's not even that good. I wonder, what does he have? He's got a short spear. All right. Probably being overly cautious at this point, but just want to make sure everyone's here. Great. All right. Let's just see what happens. Nice. Alright, I'll just let him stay here then. Of course, he gets a tiny little HP boost. Great. We won the level. Ugh, it literally took like an hour. We've taken back our country! Thank you, Micaiah. I'm not a weak little turd who's being controlled by someone, I promise. Fight for Dane! Ugh. So much talking. So much talking. I don't care! Oh, she's gonna level up. This sounds real rough. This does not sound good. It sounds like the game's gonna crash. Oh boy. Oh my gosh, that sounds terrible. Wow. Yeah, so I just got a skipped frames 26% over the last 2 minutes. Oh man, that was rough. That was real rough. Something about the Dolphin emulator does not like that music. Or the animation. I don't know. That was real bad. I don't even think the stream was catching up with everything. It was like lagging everything. I don't know what this emulator is doing. Anyway, I'm pretty sure that's the end of the Dawn Brigade in the first part. I'm pretty sure we move to Ike now. We go back to the Grell mercenaries, I think. What are you doing, dude? There we go. Big throne room. I don't remember this. Like, this little animation thing. I'm sure she's always gonna speak. No? No speaking. Great. I think these guys are going bye-bye. No problem, like, strongest character in the game. Aww. Low hug. Bye-bye. Alright. What was that sound? Aww, he's gonna stay, I think. She's got a dog person now. Wolfman, I guess. Part one, Finn. Still to come.
While Dayton celebrates its rebirth, rebellion spreads across neighboring Crimea. The young Queen Alencia holds the throne, but her nation is in turmoil. She begins to doubt her ability to rule. What will become of her country? Part two of Countries and Kings.
Whatever shall we do? Never want to play that level again. Alright, so I'm really tired and I am gonna start this part and get to a point where I can save, and then that'll be it.
Day in. Has been reborn. Word of King Peleus' coronation reaches neighboring Crimea within days. Crimea itself has spent the past 3 years rebuilding from the damage it suffered during the Mad King's War. News that Ashnard's son now sits on Dayan's throne sends waves of unease and worry rippling across the land. Alas, this is not the only thing disturbing the people of Crimea during this time. There is an ever-widening gap emerging between Crimea's noble class and the nation's young ruler, Queen Alencia.
Okay.
Crimea lost its king during the Dayan invasion, and Alencia is still an inexperienced ruler. What's more, her very existence was a secret from the public, and so she came unexpectedly to her succession. Many of Crimea's noble houses raised their voices in protest against
every single like noble or rich person in this game looks evil. I love it.
Ties with the Laguz nation of Gallia and to renounce Crimea's claim to rule over a defeated Dayan. Her political moderation is seen as a sign of weakness among her critics. Ike, the young hero who led Crimea to victory.
Oh, he looks so cool now. Still not a fan of that green headband. I don't know. Prefer the red one.
Mercenary to the nobility, however, widened the rift between the aristocracy and the queen yet further. Perhaps to avoid becoming mired in these power struggles, Ike renounced his peerage and took his leave of the court.
Good for you, Ike.
Yet Ike's actions did little to placate the nobility. They continued to criticize the queen's every decision and lay squarely at her feet the blame for all of Crimea's woes.
She's got people yelling at her now. It's just what we need. Oh, to be an aristocrat in a cutscene. It's Jill? Right? Marcia. She looks way better than she did in the first game. Blah, blah, blah. Pretty sure. Yeah, this one is a fight in the sky. Maybe I'll finish this one. Bingo. Survive for 8 turns. Jeez. Good. Keep dodging. That's all I ask. Nice. Dang, Alencia. Holy crap. You were so weak in the first game, you were useless. That's not good. Nice. Oh my gosh, she's so strong. Oh, that attack was really weak. There we go. I'm just gonna move back. Did not mean to do that. Oh well. Stun him again, man. Do whatever you did last time. Good job. All right. Hey, it's Har. He's so strong. Great. Youch. Good. Har's a good guy. He really is. Alright. Let's get this done. Should be relatively easy. Oh, I didn't realize there was a boss here. That kind of puts a damper on things. I thought I just had to survive. All right, well. All right, that's good enough. Good. You guys are doing what I said you should do. Alright, they're fine. Be gone, peasant. Oh my gosh, holy crap. This guy really did some damage. Wow, okay. Definitely wasn't supposed to happen. There you go. I mean, Marcia definitely wasn't supposed to die, so that's not good. I All right. I think that's it for tonight. Come on. That was close. Got more talking? All right, we'll go through the talking.
Queen Alyncia encounters and defeats a wing of Benyan Draco Knights trespassing in Crimean skies. After rescuing Chamberlain Mialucci and Princess Liane, she invites them to be her guests at the royal court. While Alyncia's show of loyalty to her Lagoo's allies causes an uproar among the nobles at court, they are aware that the Heron Princess is under the mutual protection of the mighty Lagoo's Hawk King and Raven King. Because of this, there is no public show of distaste. However, dissatisfaction with Alyncia's rule now spreads from a single faction to a larger group. Crimea's unity is slowly rotting from within. This discord begins to be felt even in country hamlets like the farming village of Oma.
Oma. Oh my god! Yeah, sorry, Marcia, but I've never used you in the first game, and you're essentially useless in this one, so I got no time for people I can't use pretty much immediately. Like this guy, it's Brom. And Nephany. It's the country bumpkin group. Excuse me. Yeah, I don't care. They're taking up arms against Crimea, and that's about it. We're gonna make a difference. We're young. Wow. Okay. Alright, I am definitely done for tonight. I got some stuff to take care of, but I'm happy that I was able to beat the first act of this game, which was great. Let's turn the webcam back on. Alright, so, thank you guys for watching again, really. I seriously appreciate anyone who sticks around and watch, even though I think there was only maybe two people this time who watched. Just sort of, again, par for the course for me. But again, this has been Kyle Emblem. It's just me playing through Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn, which is for the Wii. Yeah, so I'll be doing this every Wednesday at 9 p.m. And yeah, feel free to comment, stick around, get excited, retweet stuff when we retweet it. I work for Subpixel, obviously. If you weren't aware of that, you are now. We have a ton of great content that comes out every single week, and we're constantly working on new videos. Jake Terrio, part of the team, just released a new video all about video game introductions and how they can affect the game from a player perspective, and what makes a good introduction, what makes a bad introduction, all that great stuff. You can find that on our YouTube channel by just going to YouTube and searching Subpixel, or you can go to subpixelfilms.com. It'll take you right there. You can also find us at Subpixel Films. At Subpixel Team on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook, and yeah, just stick around if you're interested in video games and all the great content that we can provide. So I hope you guys join me next week, and actually, update for tomorrow, there is going to be a server quest, new server quest. It's EverQuest 2, and I think Will and Ian are going to be playing that, or Will and Ian and Zach, or some combination of those people. So yeah, get ready for that tomorrow. I believe that's at 9 p.m. So yeah, should be a good time. And with that, I will sign off for the night and hope you guys have a great night and a good rest of the week. See you guys next week.